Well, welcome. Good morning. I want to take this opportunity to thank my joint sponsor, Representative Stinziano, and he is going to also introduce the wonderful guests that are here with me behind us. What we're here to talk about, though, is a very important issue. I'm going to cover a few of the broad points, and then I want the guests behind me to give you some more details as to why this is so important. But House Bill 362 changes the Ohio Revised Code to address the need for domestic violence incidences involving strangulation to be classified as a felony. While all domestic violence cases deserve our attention, strangulation is a known indicator for increased risk of homicide. Those who have previously been in a domestic violence dispute involving strangulation are 7 times more likely to become victims of a homicide in any future domestic violence cases. The perpetrators of these crimes need to know that they are not going to keep getting away with their abuse. The time to act is now to ensure that no additional women become victims before we fail to act. 38 states currently have this legislation, and I'm determined to ensure that Ohio is going to be the 39th state. Our goal is to save women who are in this vulnerable situation. We want to connect them to the resources that are available to ensure that they become survivors and not victims. As a personal note, I'm a mother of 2 daughters, and I think it's every parent's hope and dream that their child will grow up and have a loving relationship. And we don't want any other families to endure heartbreak from these domestic violence situations, especially in something that can be preventable. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to Representative Stinziano to touch more about the bill, and he's going to introduce the rest of the guests. But thank you all for being here.
Thank you, Representative Kunze, and really appreciate her effort in this bipartisan legislation. Thank you all for being here. You will be hearing from Amy Weber and Nicole Miller, their sisters of an individual that unfortunately had a strangulation incident and subsequent homicide. Also from Nancy Neylon with the Ohio Domestic Abuse Network, Ruth Allen with the Forensic Healthcare Consulting, and Ann Murray, who works at the Columbus City Attorney's Office in the Domestic Violence and Stalking Unit Division. As Representative Kunze mentioned, the need for this legislation is both urgent and easily identifiable. As you'll hear from Monica Weber's sisters, you know, last year she died at the hands of her husband, only 9 months after he spent just 11 days in jail for strangling her until she was dizzy and unable to call for help. Where Ohio is short in our legislation, is strangulation is treated as a misdemeanor. What this legislation would do, House Bill 362, is increase the penalty for strangulation in a domestic violence situation to a third-degree felony. Typically, a third-degree felony would be on average 3 years in jail, but could be from 9 months to 5 years. And so our goal is to keep the abuser away and so that the individual can get the help, get the safety they need. As mentioned, 33 states have had this legislation in place, and it has shown to be a true decrease in domestic homicide cases. And so that's the overview of the legislation. Pretty simple, but we are definitely behind in terms of what we're doing as a state. And it's time for Ohio's laws to be reflective and protect these victims. And so we appreciate the opportunity of using Domestic Violence Awareness Month to highlight another piece of legislation that can help those abused and give a voice where they don't have one. So with that, I'd like to introduce Ms. Amy Weber.